we have prepared a presentation of this is the birthday, the 50th birthday of the book Structure des systèmes dynamiques of Jean-Marie Souriau. So I will make a short introduction which is more on the family of Souriau. We see that is a very famous family. And Jerry will give you in 45 minutes a summary of the book of Jean-Marie Souriau. So for the introduction, so my talk is on Souriau family and structure of motion. So I will talk about Jean-Marie Souriau, Michel Souriau, Paul Souriau, and Étienne Souriau. So this is the etymology of the word Souriau. So in French, souris, you have souris, and you have sourisseau for small mouse. So souris is a mouse, sourisseau is a small mouse. But in Vendômois, you have the Souriau means sourisseau. So it is a small mouse in Le Perche. Should be it is in Vendômois. So Souriau was graduated from École Normale Supérieure in Paris, and this is the student of the year 1942, and some of them are very famous because in the same promotion you have Jacques Dixmier, which is very well known for his work on enveloping algebra. You have also René De Vels, which is also the father of Paul De Vels, which is also a member of the French Academy of Science, who has written very interesting book on quadratic form on classical group, on tensors and spinners. So after being graduated from École Normale Supérieure, he follows some course given by Élie Cartan. So Élie Cartan was very old during this period, but he gives some seminar at École Normale and perhaps some lectures at Sorbonne University. So after during his interview, one of his interview, he says that at École Normale Supérieure they have received some engineers from US, and it was very very inspiring for him, and he's more oriented for a career in mathematics, but he has decided to go to ONERA, and he has made his PhD thesis on sur la stabilité des avions, so stability of airplane, in 1973. And he has proved that you can stabilize one aircraft with respect to all position of the engine. That's why in France we have made a Caravelle. So for the Caravelle, you could observe that the engine at the back. And just after in US, they have McDonnell Douglas has used the same principle, but they have paid royalties to ONERA with respect to this work of Souriau. In parallel of his PhD, he has given some lectures. He said in Grand Moulin, so I don't know if it is the site of Paris 7 now, but so he gave a lecture on algèbre multilinéaire algebra. And he has made two small books during this period. And he has invented not so well-known algorithms is to compute the characteristic function of matrices. So it's very interesting because you can use it also. So in three lines, it is an iterative algorithm. You can compute all the parameters of the characteristic function of a matrices. So you can use it to inverse a matrices. You can use it to compute the exponential map. So it's less efficient than the more classical method, but it could come back because you can parallelize these algorithms. Yes, and after you have the book of Structure des systèmes dynamiques. So I have some colleagues at the fluid mechanical department in ONERA, so they have recovered the PhD. So this is the PhD of Souriau sur la stabilité des avions. And Jean-Pierre Françoise has made some papers on this PhD. So he make not so much references, but he give one. It is a book of Yves Rocard. And you are in Amphitryum Yves Rocard, which was a well-known physicist in France, because it was the father of the nuclear French nuclear bomb. So he gives this reference of this book in his PhD. Perhaps you could give a few words on this PhD now, what you have you remind. This is your quotation. you remember now what you have seen?
I have not succeeded to find on my computer, so I don't remember exactly all the details, but there is a very interesting calculation of the stability of the linearization of the system. There is a clever linearization. It's a complicated system, of course. To prove that there is a stability, you need to check that the eigenvalues are on of modulus less than one. And so he compute explicitly this by some technique of residue. So and in fact, it is interesting because if I remember well, I hope I don't say something wrong, but the idea to compute the eigenvalues of a matrix by this algorithm, I think it was already in this thesis, if I remember well. Okay. So, in fact, what I write. Yes, so.
We could put your paper on the website. Yes, so you have many computations for this computation of stability. This is another interview given to Patrick Iglesias, where he says that he has the idea of a moment map during this period, because he has discussion with engineers at Onera on what is invariant. So they are familiar with the invariance of energy, but they have the idea that we could introduce other invariants. What he has said, in this part, he explains that it was the beginning of IBM in France, and they are looking for very complex algorithms to make a demonstration of their computer, and they have selected an algorithm of Souriau. So during this period, it was card, so you have to print your card for programming the IBM system. And they go, so they launch the program, and they go to make a drink, to have a drink, and they come back to have the result. So it was less efficient than 2 days. We have no time to take a drink. Yes, so he makes reference with algorithms invented in 1948 on the characteristic function of... Yes, and in this part, he says, yes, I have some discussion with engineers. What is essential in mechanics? Some engineers say me that mechanics is simply the principle of conservation of energy. So it is good for a system with only one parameter, but as soon as you have two, it's not sufficient. I have learned from Lagrange equation, on all the analytical principle of mechanics, but it was not so clear, and we cannot discover the real principle. So these are two other books that he has published in the Presse Universitaire de France. It's called PUF in French. It's a small book, so two volumes on calcul linéaire, where you could find the famous algorithm of Souriau to compute the characteristic function. So 1973 is the end of his PhD. It is one of his first conference in Strasbourg on géométrie différentielle. And I have discovered that you have also Jean-Luc Ossul in the conference, and Jean-Marie Souriau. But you have many famous, because you have Lichnerowicz, which was one of the supervisor of his PhD. You have also Paulette Lieberman. What is you have many famous. You have Ereshman here, I think so. You have Lichnerowicz, Ereshman, Georges Doram, Guggenheimer, Malgrange, Georges Ribb, René Thom, John Milner, André Weil. That's a very interesting conferences. And after he goes with his wife in Tunisia, especially in Carthage. And because in Tunis you have Institut des études scientifiques, but in Tunis, and I have found this video on INA website. I take some snapshot of. Institute des études scientifiques. So it was mainly isolated because there is not so much physicists and mathematicians, but more historian. And so it was a period where he has really studied the book of Lagrange during this period from 1974 to 1978. So this is another chart of Institut des études scientifiques. And yes, and she's a reference to his wife, a friend of his wife. J'allais donc, so the. Yes, so it's a friend of which has visited the Institute, and he says that I meet some colleagues from working on history, from Ecole de Rome is for art, historian of modern art. Story, lawyers, and scientific. He makes reference to Souriau. On that, he come back to Marseille. So he makes reference. So we could say that the root of the structure of system dynamic is a Mediterranean invention between Carthage and Massilia, Marseille. And I found that there is a battle. Between the two cities during Greek period. There is a reference to Élie Cartan Colloquium in 1984. I don't know why they have organized this meeting at this date, because it didn't correspond to any birthday anniversary of Cartan. Perhaps it was the creation of École Normale Supérieure de Lyon, I don't know. And you have two speakers. Well, you have many famous speakers, hein, Marcel Berger, Tcherm, Choquet-Brua, Pfefferman, Gelfand, Gromov, Guillemin, Elgason, Kac, Costant, Kossul. And you have also a talk of Souriau, un algorithme générateur de structures quantiques. A generating algorithm for a quantic structure. In fact, he develops the diffology in this paper that has been presented this afternoon. And but diffology has appeared as soon as 1980, I think so, in the Souriau paper. And I look for his family. So Jean-Marie Souriau is here. So Jean-Marie Souriau is son of Michel Souriau. And if you look, so it's Paul Souriau, his grandfather, was aggregate, was also as a diploma from École Normale Supérieure, but in philosophy. And especially he makes his Latin thesis on motus perceptione. I have the objective to translate in French and in English this thesis. This is a short thesis, it was what called a short thesis during this period. And the main one is on theory of invention. And he has made a book that you can find on Amazon, L'esthétique du mouvement. It's a very interesting book where this philosopher tried to understand why we consider that this kind of movement is more beautiful than another one, the movement of animals and so on. You have also his grand uncle, Maurice Souriau, which has a work on history of literature, and he has received 4 prizes of French Academy of Science, Académie Française, sorry. And you have also his uncle, Étienne Souriau, also graduated from École Normale Supérieure, which was also a ranking one at aggregation in philosophy. And it was a colleague of Gaston Bachelard at Sorbonne University. And it was the supervisor of the PhD of Alain René, which is a famous filmmaker in France. And the last one is Michel Souriau, which was also graduated from École Normale Supérieure in philosophy. So you could see that in his family he has 3 philosophers from École Normale Supérieure. So I am assume that he has read L'esthétique du mouvement, and we could observe that in the approach of physics you have this philosophical approach of science. And especially in his last book, Grammaire de la Nature, it's a mix between science and philosophy. So it's interesting because we have 3 generations which has worked on the same kind of structures. So Souriau has worked on the structure of motion. His grandfather has worked on aestheticism of motion, and his grand uncle has worked on the structure of aestheticism. So this is a picture of Paul Souriau, his grandfather at École Normale Supérieure. And this is a picture at Sorbonne University with Gaston Bachelard and Étienne Souriau. Okay. And so I will give the floor to Jerry. So you have also information on the website of Souriau 2019, and especially the video of Jean-Pierre Bourguignon on testimony of his discussion on the discovery of the book of Souriau. And you have also an interview of Souriau in French. We explain his career in science. Okay. So I give the floor to Ferry.
Thank you very much. I accepted with enthusiasm the proposition of Frédéric to give this presentations in the occasion of the 5th birthday of this famous book of Jean-Marie Souriau, Structure des systèmes dynamiques. But really it's a very hard task because the book is the size of 400 pages, and it is very, very dense. And so it's a challenge to cover all the topics in a short time. So I prepared a text, sorry, because I had no time to prepare, and I prefer to read this text. Jean-Marie Souriau's book, Structure des systèmes dynamiques, was published in 1970 in a book collection for students in the first year of master degrees in mathematics. Directed, in fact, to mathematicians, beginners, or above all, experimented, wishing to know the application of mathematics to physical sciences. And to physicists concerned with knowing certain mathematical tools useful for their researches. The author was very aware of this since in his introductions, very interesting, he gives reading recommendations adapted to both readers' categories. It is a work with an exceptional wealth, which 50 years after his publications is still topical. Some words about his life that was already evoked by Frédéric. Graduated of the École Normale Supérieure in 1942, Jean-Marie Souriau obtains the aggregation of mathematics in 1945, ranked second. After a brief passage at the CNRS, he joins as an engineer the ONERA, recently created, and prepares his PhD thesis on the airplane stability. Defending in 1952, this work was used for the design of several airplanes, in particular the Caravelles, but other ones also, the Concorde, famous Concorde. Next, he obtains a position as professor at Tunis in 1952 and at Aix-Marseille University in 1964, where he published and Structure des systèmes dynamiques in 1970. For more details on Jean-Marie Souriau's life and personality from his friends, you can read the paper paying homage to him in the Gazette des Mathématiciens, but only in French. More surprisingly, we find here Jean-Marie Souriau as cartoon character. In this scene drawn by the physicist Jean-Pierre Petit, the guy to the left asks, why do you use sunglasses to read Souriau's structure of dynamical systems? And the other one answers, because its simplicity is blinding. This is another homage, but with a thread of humor. Before to go further, let's point out that the original edition is out of print. After all, it's possible to find copies of second hand. Happily, it was republished recently by Gavet, the book at the center. It was also translated in English and published under the title Structure of Dynamical Systems, a Symplectic Use of Physics. This traduction was supervised by Richard Cushman and Gay Stoneman, who have known very well the author. If you are very impatient, you can download the scanned version, not of good quality, from Jean-Marie Souriau official website, and a lot of other interesting papers and books. The book SSD begins by a large introduction. Begins by a large introduction of 20 pages, in which Souriau highlights the guiding ideas. He considers the classical analytical mechanics that remains an essential ingredient of the current physical theories is not outdated. certain use concept SOAR because they had no the required covariance. In other words, because they are in contradiction with Galilean relativity. He wishes to show in his book that a better considerations of Lagrange's thought allows giving to this theory a form compatible with the more recent discoveries of the physical science. In the first chapter, Souriau presents in less than 70 pages numerous tricky notions from differential manifolds to Lie groups and calculus of variations. The author presents the concept of differential manifold in a rather original way, bypassing the one of topological space, undoubtedly to make these notions easily accessible to beginning students. The differential manifolds are not supposed Hausdorff. Examples of non-Hausdorff manifolds, such as the space of motions of certain mechanical system, will be indeed encountered in chapter 3. Note that Hausdorff's language, could cause confusions. He calls embedding what most of geometers call injective immersions. This was corrected in the English version. This choice is very reasonable because injective immersions are much more frequently encountered than embeddings in the concerned applications. For example, orbits of Lie groups, action, as well as leaves of a foliation, always are immersed in the manifold in which they are contained and much more rarely embedded. The book is illustrated by many figures which mostly are very meaningful schematic representation of the geometric constructions used by the author. For instance, this one in which A is an element of a Lie group G, is an identity. A underline J, G, is the action of A on the group by the operation. The cursive G is the Lie algebra, the infinitesimal generator. These notations, you can meet them in the whole book. At the right hand, you have a manifold V on which the group acts by the action denoted A underline V, the infinitesimal action ZV of X at X, and also represented an orbit. As you see, the notations are often very non-standard, but they are totally consistent. Chapter 2 is also essentially mathematical, but shorter than the previous one. It starts with algebraic notions concerning the antisymmetric tensors, then two forms, denoted sigma. If sigma is regular, is non-degenerated, it is called symplectic, otherwise presymplectic. So it has a non-null kernel. Next, Souriau defines the symplectic and presymplectic manifolds and studies their properties. He showed that under certain conditions, the caution at the right end of a presymplectic manifold V at the left end by its kernel is a symplectic manifold. Result that he will use later on to define the space of motions of a dynamical system that plays a central role in his theory. The elements of the quotients are leaves of a characteristic foliation. Below, it's important definitions. Let U be a differentiable function, scalar field on B, defined on this symplectic manifold. DU is a one form. If the form sigma is symplectic, that is regular, there exists a unique vector associated to du that it denotes grad of u and called symplectic gradient. Let's remark in passing the non-standard notation sigma of grad u for the interior product of the vector grad u and the form sigma. In the first, Soyo called dynamical group that other authors call symplectic group of a symplectic or presymplectic manifold M, a Lie group acting on it by canonical transformation. That is, it preserve the symplectic or presymplectic form. It let it invariant. Another very important notion. He calls moment of the dynamical group G a differential map psi from a point X at the right end, a point of the manifold M, onto an element mu of the vector space G star dual of the Lie algebra G of the group. Such that for every generator, infinitesimal generator Z, it's the infinitesimal action is the symplectic gradient, as defined before, of the function linking at every point x the function of value mu dot z, that is the value of mu for z. The author gives several examples of dynamical groups, indicates sufficient condition for a dynamical group admitting a moment and studies its properties. This leads him to propose a generalization of Noether's theorem. We arrive to one of the most original Soyo theories, the symplectic cohomology of Lie groups, already evoked in this summer school. In one end, take the value mu of the moment pad psi at x. Next, apply the coadjoint representations in one end. On the other hand, we let the element A, act on X. Next, we take the value of the moment map psi. So you prove that the difference it doesn't depend on the point X on the manifold. So it is uniquely a function of the group element A, that it denotes theta. This defines a map, theta, from the group to the dual of its Lie algebra. It verifies an identity at the right hand of the art, called the cocycle identity. That means that the group acts on the moment space by affine representations. With linear part, the coadjoint representation, and the translation part is this function theta of A. The differential of theta at the identity, denoted F in this book, it was the caps theta, I think, in your presentations, is a bilinear form on the dual. And it is not obvious, it has to be proved, it is anti-symmetric. Then it is a two-form. And it verifies an identity below that generalizes Jacobi's one. The map theta measures the defect of symplectic cohomology of the dynamical group. It depends only on the group, and it is called symplectic cocycle. It is possible also to define symplectic co-boundaries and passing to the quotients to define class of symplectic cohomology. We arrive to another fundamental result called now Kirillov-Constant-Suriot theorems. The main contribution of Suriot is concerning the case of non-vanishing class of symplectic cohomology. In fact, it is not necessary to study case by case the action of a dynamical group on every symplectic manifold. You can disregard the manifold and take interest only on the action of the group onto the dual of its Lie algebra, G star. Then, on each orbit U contained in this space, there exists a canonical symplectic structure, and the identity map of the orbit is a moment map. In other words, we may say that each point mu of the orbit U is its own moment. This is a very important result, very simple and nice. The chapter 3 is, in my opinion, the main chapter of the book, after the purely mathematical developments, and before the extension to thermodynamics, statistical mechanics, and quantum mechanics. It is devoted to the applications to mechanics. The starting point is the following two form sigma that Suriot attributes to Lagrange and calls the Lagrange form. The Lagrange form of a system of material points is the sum of the Lagrange forms of all points of the system, where mj is the mass of the particle j, rj is its position, vj its velocity, and fj is a resultant of the forces acting upon it. You can observe here one of the peculiarities of Suriot's notation. It does not use the symbol lambda for the exterior product. of differential forms, which has some advantage but also drawbacks. That will be discussed in the paper we shall publish with Charles-Michel Marr on the book. Then, the well-known equation of motion can be written in a very compact form. The tangent vector to delta y, to the trajectory in the evolution space of the time, the positions of the particle and their velocities of dimension 1 plus 6n for n particles, belongs to the kernel of the presymplectic form. Next, Souriau defines the vector Ej in terms of the force Fj and occurring in Lagrange two forms, and a new vector Bj freely chosen. This leads him to formulate what he calls Maxwell's principle in the following form. The vector fields Bj may be chosen in such a way that the Lagrange form is closed. Hence, this condition determines these fields in a unique manner. Stating this principle, the author proves that the field Ej and Bj don't depend on the velocities of the material points. A result which is not obvious. Bj does not depend on the position of other particle than J. These two fields, Ej and Bj, verify a condition in which we recognize Maxwell's reciprocity principle. In fact, a version of the action and reaction principle for force acting at distance. And they verify, finally, two equations in which we recognize Faraday equation and the law of inductions or absence of magnetic monopoles. By contrast, Ampere and Gauss equations of electromagnetism are relativistic effects which don't appear. Souriau adopts Maxwell's principle as a new law of the mechanics, not only of the electromagnetism, and present various examples. The n-body problem of the celestial mechanics, the gravitation where E is the usual gravity force, and B is producing Coriolis force, and of course the electromagnetic field. Without denying the importance of the principle of least action, or even the usefulness of this formalism, the author declares this concept seems to him less fundamental as the Maxwell principle. The chapter 3 is, one of the originality of Souriau's work is to emphasize the role played by the space of motions. Starting from the evolution space at the left hand, which is equipped with a presymplectic structure. The space of motion has a symplectic structure, so is of an even dimension. It is obtained by caution of the foliation, each leaf representing a trajectory of a particle. The space of motions of a dynamical system is not very often considered by modern authors. So, it appeared as soon as 1880 in the work of Lagrange. This very natural concept has a nice mathematical properties. The space of motions is always endowed with a smooth manifold structure. One may wonder why the concept of space of motion is not used more by modern authors. Maybe it's because for some dynamical systems, not all, the space of motion is non-Hausdorff manifold. Another possible explanation is that some scientists are interested in the thorough description of particular motions of a system rather than by the study of the set of all possible motions. By showing that many important results can be deduced from the symmetries of the space of motions of a system, Souriau proved that this reluctance is unfounded. Next, Souriau introduced Galilei group, or Galileo's group, the symmetry group of the classical mechanics, early group of dimension 10, with its notation A is the rotation, B is the Galilean boost, C space translation, E time translation. The infinitesimal generator, Z, below, represented also in a matrix form for the convenience of calculus, lives in its Lie algebra. In the paragraph, when the system is isolated, Galileo group acts onto the evolution space and the space of motions by quotient. On the evolution space, the moment of this action is a first integral of the motion, if the system is isolated, of course. The author details its 10 components, which can be regrouped in three vectors, P, L, and G, and a scalar E. It gives their physical meaning. P is a total, it is here. P is a total linear momentum. L is a total angular momentum. It's something absent in the classical treatise, ignore moment by many people. The equality G equal constant conveys the fact that the center of mass moves on a straight line at constant velocity. It is named by Souriau the passage. The scalar E, defined modulo an additive constant, is the total energy. By a calculation similar to Bergman's one, Souriau proved that the symplectic homology of Galileo group is of dimension 1. He considers the number M that spots the class of symplectic homology of the action of Galileo group on the space of motions as is the mass of the particle. In the paragraph, the principles of symplectic mechanics, the author first takes place in the frame of the classical mechanics, non-relativistic, the red box, above. He's no longer limited to the system of material points, and he adopts the three following assertions as new axioms of the mechanics. One, the space of the motion of dynamical system is a connected symplectic manifold. Two, if several dynamical systems evolve independently, the manifold of motions of the composite system is a symplectic direct product of the space of motion of the component systems. Three, if a dynamical system is isolated, its manifold of motions admits the Galileo group as a dynamical group. It is an extension of the principles generally admitted of the classical mechanics, which will allow to the author considering new dynamical system having a physical interest. In special relativity, the passage of a Lorentz frame to another one is made by the action of an element of the restricted Poincaré group. The transition to relativistic case consists in a simple change of the symmetry group in the third action. In a long section, the author proposes a mechanistic description of elementary particles. In the framework of relativistic mechanics and isolated dynamical system, he said to be elementary when the Poincaré group acts transitively on the space of its motions. The moment map of its action is then a symplectic diffeomorphism of this space onto a coadjoint orbit of the Poincaré group of dimension 8. For him, so defined, elementary systems are mathematical models for the elementary particle of physicists. Besides the classical energy momentum denoted caps P, Suryo introduces, it's above, at the top, the polarization for vector W, built from P, and the moment M associated to the infinitesimal Lorentz transformation. Through a linear map denoted star, transforming an anti-Hermitian operator into another anti-Hermitian operator. As example, let's consider, this is the first case, let's consider a particle with spin. It is when P is time-like and W, which being orthogonal to P, is space-like, is non-zero. It is characterized by two invariants. M, it is the mass stemming from the energy momentum, P, and the spin, S, from the polarization. The classification of the coadjoint orbits of Poincaré's group provides us the table of elementary particles. It is a classification of relativistic particles. I treated in the previous slide case one, a particle with spin, but you have also case two, a particle without spin. It is when P is time-like and W is null. Case three is a massless particle. For instance, application to the photon. It is when both P and W are non-zero and light-like. The author defines three real numbers, the sign of the energy, eta, the helicity key, and the spin S. Finally, the non-relativistic particles are obtained by scaling of lengths and times, next considering the limit when the velocity approaches zero. Okay. The chapter 4 is devoted to statistical mechanics. It contains two sections. The first one is a very condensed course in measure theory and integration with some notion in probability. The second one presents the principle of statistical mechanics in a very original way based on the Lie group theory that was discussed already today. So you call generalized Gibbs probability law here. Any completely continuous probability law of density F given by this formula, where small z is a scalar, cap z is an infinitesimal generator living in the Lie algebra of the group, and psi is the moment map such that the law is integrable. Then he establishes the relation between the entropy S, the Planck's potential, or Massieu potential, Z, and the mean value M of the moment psi. The author explained that the entropy of the system increases when with the time, so assuming that the natural equilibria of the gas are elements of the Gibbs set of the group of time translation is a very reasonable assumption. Each Gibbs state is determined by an element Z of the one-dimensional Lie algebra of this group, which is a way of measuring the gas temperature. Since the group of time translation is a subgroup of Galilei's group, but not a normal subgroup, a dynamical system conservative in some inertial reference frame is not conservative in a different inertial reference frame. This important remark leads Souriau to introduce the new concept of covariance statistical mechanics by proposing the following general principle in the red box. When a dynamical system is invariant by the action of some Lie subgroup G prime of Galilei group, its natural equilibria are the elements of the Gibbs set of the action of G prime. Then he discusses in greater detail several examples, among them a gas in a centrifuge. This relative motion is now a rotation around an axis at a constant angular velocity. He considers also a system made by particles with spin and finds that the most probable orientation of the particle spin is parallel to the rotation axis. The theory of, yes, this is the last chapter devoted to quantum mechanics. The theory of geometric quantizations was developed in the early 70s independently by Souriau and Constant in order to bring into focus some vaguely perceived analogy between representation theory and quantum mechanics that had for a long time been part of the folklore of modern physics. The author defines a quantum manifold, Y, at the top, as a smooth manifold endowed with a contact one form, denoted omega, a presymplectic structure for the exterior differential sigma of omega, such that all integral curves are the orbits of an action on y of the one-dimensional torus. The set of these curves, in other words, the quotient of y by this action, is a symplectic manifold called by the author the base of the quantum manifold. In practice, the physicist only knows the space of motion, which is accessible to the direct experiment, to the intuition. He knows the space of motion of the classical systems, and he has to address the following issue. Is there a quantum manifold Y and a symplectomorphism from the base of Y onto the space of motion? This is the problem of the quantization, curiously traduced in the English edition by the word pre-quantization. So Yo proposes different techniques and criteria to perform this quantization. As example, he proved that the relativistic particle with spin is quantizable if and only if the spin is an integer of a half integer of h bar. Isomorphism of quantum manifolds are called by the author quantomorphism. Any quantomorphism between two quantum manifolds projects onto a symplectomorphism between their bases. A group gamma of quantomorphism of a quantum manifold Y project onto a group of symplectomorphism of its basis U, denoted G. And its projection is a group homomorphism. Conversely, a group G of symplectomorphism of the basis of the base U is said to be liftable if there exists a group gamma at the left hand side of quantomorphism of Y which project onto it. Existence is not ensured. Then Suryo discusses the quantization of a dynamical group of a quantizable symplectic manifold U with the quantum manifold Y as quantization. He proves that when a dynamical group of U is quantizable, its symplectic homology is zero. He gives examples which prove that this necessary condition is not sufficient. A dynamical group of U which is liftable but not quantizable may have an extension which still is a dynamical group of U and is quantizable. All this deep analysis on geometric basis allow to give solid foundation to the well-known correspondence principle of quantum mechanics. Let be a smooth function U on the space of motion, representing an observable for the physicist. I recall that the symplectic gradient of U is a unique vector associated by the symplectic form sigma to the differential of U. Then Suryo explains how to associate to any observable U defined on the base U an operator U hat on the Hilbert space H of Y of the state vectors psi of the quantum manifold Y, defined by this relation, where the notation delta U, not standard, means that the derivative of psi in the direction of the symplectic gradient of U. Then Suryo proved rigorously that the operator U hat is Hermitian. The map U to U hat is linear and injective. For the function U equal 1, constant, U hat is the identity of the Hilbert space. And he proved the correspondence between quantum commutators and Poisson brackets originally proposed by Dirac. When reading this book, we cannot fail to be impressed by the extent and the thoroughness of the author's knowledge, as well in mathematics as in mechanics and physics, and by the originality and the depth of his thought. We would like also to bring our attention to the fact that Jean-Marie Suryo is, as said Frédéric, the author of two other very remarkable books in French, both published in 65, The Calcul Linéaire and also Geometry and Relativity. In that respect, I would like to recall the origin of the last of the book Calcul Linéaire. From 1958, while Suryo is still engineer at ONERA, his taste for the teaching drives him to create a free course and free of charge entitled New Methods of Mathematical Physics, as shown in this poster. It is a great success. The amphitheater, even able to contain 200 persons, is full, and he has to teach twice. The program of the linear algebra gave rise to the book Calcul Linéaire. Geometry and Relativity and Calcul Linéaire, which two are very rich and original, deserves as structure des systèmes of dynamical system, structure des systèmes dynamiques, to be read and read again. A presentation of the book will be published soon in the peer review open access Memox journal. Thank you very much for your attention.
You mentioned that in some chapter, Suryo talked about or made rigorous this comparison between quantum mechanics and classical mechanics. Did I understand correctly? Did he comment at all on Ehrenfest's theorem?
Question. So
So for your information, in fact, Suryo has prepared a second edition of his book. I've never published, so with Jerry, we have the manuscript of this book, but we have not the agreement of the family to make it public. But it's a very interesting second edition because he has added some chapters. So perhaps his family will accept second edition or extended edition of the book. But there is the existence. There is also many papers by Suryo.
Yes, you can find on the official website of Jean-Marie Suryo a lot of papers. Also the scan of the books Geometry and Relativity. Not the calcul linéaire, but it was... it was published, republished in a good quality scan versions by Gabay Edition. Unfortunately, these two last books are only in French, but it's a very big work to translate them.
Scan in electronic version the grammar de la nature, grammar of nature, which is very interesting. Yes, yes. And there is different levels, so it's for very beginner until expert. Yeah, the red or and black. Yes, and for example, in the appendix, you have the use of these algorithms of characteristic function computation, how to apply it for computation of exponential map. You have many interesting also in appendix, and it is also a philosophical book.
Yes,
but even there are unpublished original results. It's very, very, very interesting book.
Thank you for your attention, and I hope that we succeed to convince you to read the Suryo book. Thank you.